Hello, good afternoon, good evening, or good morning, depending on when you're watching the video. This is Ryan, and this is the Bobcast, and Above the Brotherhood channel. We're playing a brand new game today. It was previously titled Number 4, because it's the fourth game by the studio Behemoth. You may know them as the creators of Castle Crashers or Battle Block Theater.
Or the first game.
Or possibly Alien Hominid, which was their first game. And I'm joined with Noah. Say hi, Noah.
Hello, guys.
And we're playing this video game together. We're doing some couch co-op. Now, we played just a little bit to make sure we knew how it worked, right?
Definitely.
And I'm sure there's a whole bunch more that we haven't quite figured out yet, but we're going to explore that together with you guys. This game has a special place for us because I would say Castle Crashers, and I'm actually going to... I don't want to start yet because I want to make sure that you guys can hear the narration when it comes time, but Castle Crashers...
was my first game that I learned how to play.
Yeah, absolutely.
Video game.
And we got to play it together, couch co-op, just like we're doing now. So a few years later, we're doing it again, and it has all the same flavor that Castle Crashers and Battle Block did with the narration. This is the old game. Okay, this is what we started just to make sure we knew how to do that. Let's exit the main menu. Here we go. We'll get to that town by the end of the video, probably, but... it's going to take us a second to get there. I want you guys to see it from the beginning. This is what I selected, right?
This is what you just went into.
All right. You're right. So how excited are you to play the game?
I'm very excited since Battle Block Theater was really good, and so was Castle Crashers, but we have yet to play Alien Humans.
Alien Hominid? I think it was a mobile game.
Yeah, it was? Well, Castle Crashers has a different version, and it's...
I don't know how to start a new game.
This?
Oh, here we go. So these were the previous saves we were working with, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just delete the number one spot.
Are you going to delete the second one, too?
Nah, it's all right.
Okay.
All the early access. Oh wow, that was loud. Oh, that was really loud. The game is tricky because I wanted to do
I find myself wondering what the world must have been like before the bear crashed into our frail planet, transforming all we once knew into a colorful kaleidoscope of delicious chaos, and I love it. The world was more hospitable, no doubt, more orderly, more sensibly sickening because it sounded boring, and I hate being bored. I can't imagine a world without the bear or the storms, yes, the storms. Beautiful waves of emerald blood cry down from the heavens, promising death in lawless disarray, constantly upsetting the order. I get butterflies in my tummy just thinking about it. Yes, yes! Speaking of which, let's see. Oh, it's Horatio, the humble blueberry farmer, loving father, and the most boring creature on the face of this planet. But what's this? Looks like you've got a spicy situation on your hands, Well, it's been nice knowing you, Horatio. Not really. But now it's time for you to die. Yes, how exciting. Not for you, of course.
There's still narration going on in the background there, though. We turned down just a little bit.
Yeah!
said Horatio dies. Said Horatio dies! Oops! Butterfingers!
How you say? Sorry, become rich! Alright! Hey, good! Eat that! Good, I think I'm old!
With nothing but a handful of blueberries and a stupid look on his face, Horatio set out to find some shelter, burdened with the realization that none of this would have happened had he listened. And to make matters worse, he's got weak arms, and he's not all that handsome. I don't see what all the fuss is about. But all of this will haunt him until I decide to end his misery. What fun. What's this? A beautiful lady. She looks hungry. Horatio shared his blueberries.
Hey, I know you got it!
No, you shared your berries.
Huh?
How generous of you.
How did you
her win? Name was Pipistrella, and though she looked more than capable, she requested Horatio's aid. You see, her castle was raided by grumpy warriors, and she doesn't like that very much. Go on, my little hero. Perhaps this could become a mutually beneficial relationship.
Dude, my wife is standing right there.
We devil have a monster now!
Pippa se frise!
whatever. Tony won't be with. Master, no, he's still devil. You say.
Dile, quello come di popo.
Chaotic job, gentlemen. Go wreak havoc elsewhere. Oh, sorry, Pip. Are you upset? With her castle in ruins and a very dead daddy, Pipistrella accompanies Captain Worthless, and what a woman. Her optimistic outlook and reckless bravery captivated Horatio. So much, in fact, that he immediately forgot about his son and his home and... Yes, you did.
How did you wish that way?
I see. Horatio gave Pipistrella the remainder of his blueberries, and they headed for the city. The perfect place to recuperate and make plans for Horatio's inevitable failure and death. Plus, there's a pretty good restaurant there that... Yes, the city! How it bustles with excitement! Keep your wallet in your front pocket.
Thank you.
double kill, yes! They had won the battle. Horatio kissed Joseph on the lips and then stabbed him in the stomach. Now, you really should listen to me, Horatio.
Snooky pokey, mushtoony doo, and tonky wonka wonky nong. Snooky pokey, mushtoony doo, linky winky, binky bong bong, elosh nana, and tonky wonka wonky nong. Nobody would.
Oh, Thank you. for Holoku.
Cristina la pide o respeto.
Espese por proper de Ionia.
Kurai kala, eh?